What do you do as game developers when you don't want to use an overused setting, and when you're not confident that you'll be historically accurate if you make a realistic setting for the game? Easy. Just make a what-if setting and build a game around that. And that's exactly what the developers of Freedom Fighters decided to do. The game's premise is the question, what if Russia won the Cold War in Europe and in Asia? And then, what if Russia decided to invade the United States and actually succeeded in that as well? That's what happens in Freedom Fighters. Now, ignoring the fact that such a scenario is very improbable, if not downright impossible, the game goes farther down the unrealistic route by making the protagonist a simple, ordinary plumber, who eventually becomes the leader of the resistance force fighting against the oppressive Soviet regime. I don't know about you, but that premise isn't exactly what I call original. But hey, it's a fun premise. But the thing is, unoriginality is not why this game's story actually fails. I don't know what other people might have thought about the game's story, or if they even give it some thought, but it's pretty much downright ridiculous and far-fetched. Some of the events that happen in the game are just so random and so unbelievable that I often found myself wondering while I was continuing to play the game. I still can't understand how a plumber guy can single-handedly invade an enemy headquarters and assassinate one of the Soviet generals that is guarded by tens of trained enemy soldiers. Now, I don't really care if my main character was the son of the great general or whatever, and that's totally not really explained all that well in the game, because even that's implausible. Just being a son of a great legendary general doesn't actually make you a great soldier who can take down trained soldiers and assassinate a Soviet general. But if the implausibility stops there, I wouldn't be complaining this much. The actual storyline is actually a lot worse. The fact that the powerful Soviet army that claimed victory against tens of different powerful nations, including the United States, could not succeed in invading the main character's rebel base army, which is under the sewers, guarded by 20 or so people, makes the game's storyline very, very unrealistic. But it's not really about the storyline in this game. It's the gameplay. It pretty much plays like every other third-person shooter out there, but in a rather arcadey fashion. Just think of it kind of like, I mentioned GTA here, but that's pretty much what it is. You have a GTA shooting mechanic featuring simple squad controls and that military action feel. It's not extremely awesomely great, it's not original, but hey, it's fun, somewhat. If the game was any longer than what it already is, this game, it's about 10 hours playtime long, and it's just about the perfect length. Any longer, and I think it'd be way too repetitive, you know? I admit the setting and the atmosphere of the game is quite unique in a way. The way it's told is not original at all. But, I mean, and the actual premise, you know, oh, so what if Russia won the Cold War? You know, it's totally what you expect. But the way it's kind of told, the atmosphere in books, is pretty cool. It's that bleak and that despondent atmosphere given off by a really interesting musical score, which is a fusion of American rock and Russian opera, you know, and that musical score is really what makes this whole entire atmosphere come to life and makes it incredible. The repetitive nature of the game is actually not that bad because a lot of the levels have varying and pretty unique objectives. A lot of people love this game because of that unique atmosphere feel, but I don't know, I've seen a lot of people say this is like the best game ever or something like that, and I feel like that's really ignoring the completely flawed and far-fetched storyline, and also it ignores the fact that the gameplay, while great, is actually kind of generic. It really doesn't bring too much new to the table of shooters. It just is marked by pretty decent level design and fairly good gunplay mechanics with squad controls of an AI that is decent. It's not that bad. It's not like Halo 3 AI, Ally AI, or Halo 2 for that matter. Halo 2 was worse. You know, Ally AI is actually competent. You know, and the gameplay works. The gunplay works. But, you know, it's just that kind of game where you just want gonna grab some popcorn, enjoy it, rent it, move on to the next game kind of game.